meeting tonight to remember and reflect on events which took place in China, specifically in Tiananmen Square in June of 1989.
But today with us is a different Tang Mank. The Tang did not stop. Instead, actually the Tang chased him from behind and crashed, and that's how he lost his two legs. And I think it's a great honor today for me to be here with Mr. Fang Zheng and to translate for him as well. Very briefly about 1989, in case if you don't have any background information. In spring 1989, millions of Chinese took to the street demanding for political reform. The peaceful demonstrations and the hunger strike in Tiananmen Square ended on June 4th with the People's Liberation Army firing on its own people under the gaze of the entire world. Came over to me and she said, "I'm really scared." And I felt that as a man, as a guy, and I'm older than her, and I just told her that, "Don't worry, I'm confident that I can protect you, you'll be fine, you'll be okay." Because throughout my education experience, it's just beyond our belief that the People's Army will fire on us.
So, for one example, this censorship on Tiananmen isn't just happening inside China. It's now going beyond Chinese boundaries. This year we saw for the first time two Hong Kong, a politician and a student leader, had been invited to Malaysia to speak at a talk, to give a talk about Tiananmen, and they were turned away at the Malaysian border for fear of harming ties with Malaysia. We've seen American companies like LinkedIn and Skype, who are censoring content on the internet regarding June the 4th, regarding Tiananmen, because they want to safeguard their ties with the Chinese market. They want to create value. That was the word of the LinkedIn spokesman. Create value for their customers. So I think that given these moves, it's important to speak up and to be heard and to say that, you know, people who have a voice need to use it to stop this censorship from encroaching upon the rest of the world.
Thank you. first movement, when I thought of the democracy wall, I thought of actually Shen Deng's story about his father. And he would go to that wall and copy poetry because it couldn't be published. There's no magazines, there's no internet. And he would copy the poetry because that's the only time he could read modern poetry. And when that was suppressed, he was worried about being caught with all these copies. So he couldn't burn it because the neighbors and the snitches in the neighborhood would see the fire in the chimney. So they tore up the paper and they dissolved it and until it could be flushed down the latrine and no one would notice. And so I did feel that connection then to the triangle because that was the democracy wall of Tiananmen. And I just try to imagine. And I tell you, when I say I read, it's like my conversations with Rowena and Louisa's book, you know, it just made me have this feeling instead of the idea, but the feeling of living a lie, not being able to express yourself, not being able to share ideas for generations. And it's ingrained into the system. It's hard to imagine. So I thought that act of then expressing oneself, posting a big character poster at the triangle was extraordinarily courageous and new, perhaps, for many that did so.
And in the hearts of so many of my generation. And so that's not an ending after all. And tonight you just make that alive. And I really would like to thank you for doing that for us. Maybe Fang Zheng.
Yeah. 真的非常感动在这里，有这么多音乐家用音乐的形式来表达对26年前的世界的没有遗忘。音乐是世界的语言，我想全世界的人都能听得懂，都能知道你们在表达的是一种什么样的心情。我非常感谢你们。
I'm really grateful to you all because music is an international language. We do not need to speak that language to understand those emotions, and I'm very grateful that you're doing that for us.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, please, let's honor the presence of Fang Zheng here with us as one of the survivors of the Tiananmen Square and one of the people that said, I challenge, and I do it for freedom. Thank you very much.
Thank you.